I'm like, man, this shit's funny. I gotta show the stream. Hold on real quick. Using ice slide is not how you beat me. I could just sit there and duck. And you didn't resub, so let's see. Maybe we should get you timed out for 1 hour. Hey, Mods, time out that person for 1 hour? Thank you. I just literally fucking said, I know the fucking goddamn frame data to the entire game. Enough. All right, so I'm not gonna watch the whole 23 minutes, but this idiot thinks I don't know how to, like, I guess, play fighting games to that type of level. When I tell you guys I play fighting games at 2%, it's got 31,000 views 5 days ago because there's a lot of broke bum ass niggas that can't figure out how to beat Ninja Stars when you can literally just duck them in the game. But it's called layer gameplay. You duck them. I got answers for that too. All right. How to stop low tier guys Rego spam. You know, somebody made a Smash video like this. How to stop low tier guys. What is it? How to stop low tier guys Belmont bullshit. I'm like, I keep telling these bum niggas, when I play, I seen Destiny's wife ask for 100 bands. Nah, but you could link one of my mods in the video and they'll get it to me. Preferably, Dreddy. PM him on here, he'll get it.
Named Low Tier God, or also known as LTG.
You are worthless.
Is best known for losing and raging in video games.
Best known for raging and losing in video games. That's not how I'm best known. When people come up to me in person, they don't even mention video games. They'd be like, damn, I fuck with the streams. Like, I remember when you said this, that. Nobody mentions video games. So if you're still talking about video games in 2023's Low Tier God, you're a fucking idiot. You're a fucking moron. All right, let's go ahead and get to the rest of this corny shit. Showing old ass 2015 clips. All right, let's get to the dumb shit. Poorly made video, by the way.
Right. LTG Ninja Star to win.
So this is clearly some broke ass nigga that watches my streams 24/7. That watches this bum ass broke ass nigga streams.
Oh, yo! Shout out to the dude who plugged in my restream, bro. Thank you. Much love to you, bro. Appreciate that shit.
Now, does it look like... All right, the thing is... All right, let's not show this on my screen. So the thing is, guys, when you watch me play...
Yo, big ups to all you motherfuckers that be plugging in the restream, man. Thank you.
Just click from that whole person stream. So I really don't even
want
to show
how mad this dude is, bro.
But when you watch me play MK, does it look like I'm playing for real?
Zeus sees my reach.
Like, if you ever seen somebody really play fighting games, does it really look like I'm really playing? Nigga, I'm kicking back. That's why we have a good time in MK.
What's good, low tier god? I wasn't able to get much this Christmas, but I'm glad you're here being a lit personality for us to enjoy. Thank you so much for the.
I'll be right back, guys.
And the 31 bands.
You're welcome, nigga. Now sprinkle some in your tongue, bitch. Anyways, I'm literally, when I play MK, aren't we just hoping that I kick back, spam Ninja Stars, and piss people off? Nigga, I combo if I want to, but for the most part, the whole reason of us cutting on MK is to literally watch me spam Ninja Stars so we could piss niggas off. That's the whole aura of me playing MK1. Like, I don't sit there and be like, you know what, let me just master all the fucking combos. Like, I know what's negative, I know what's plus, all that type of dumb shit. It takes 5 minutes to lab your character in this game. Like, you know what you can and cannot do, bro. The whole point is to sit there and spam Ninja Stars and have a good fucking time. Like, yeah, like, that's the whole point. I'm not sitting over here studying the fucking frame data. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make sure you better just do voiceovers from this point when you upload my shit, because from now on, I'm gonna just make sure I play straight up copywritten shit through every fighting game that I play from now on. Every single one. I'll tell you guys the last time I was serious in fighting games or tried to even take it remotely serious was 2018. No bullshit. After that, I was just like, the fuck for? Like, I could literally just play casually, still be low tier guy, do the bare minimum, basically try to beat niggas at the bare minimum, and that's it. And I'm gonna talk some shit online because it's fun to do that. Yeah, E-League was like the last time. And before E-League, I wasn't even studying frame data in games. It wasn't until the E-League show that I was studying frame data. That was it. Outside of that, I was blindly playing fighting games and beating lots of niggas in classic fighting games with knowing no frame data. So technically, I didn't even start fucking with frame data until 2018. Yeah, the fucking reality show I did that I got paid $500 for. Everybody got paid $500 for being on national TV. That shit. It will work. Speeding it up doesn't work because it's just like doing a reaction. If you try to speed up the audio or dub it, YouTube will still pick it up. I know what the fuck I'm talking about. What show was that? It was called, what the fuck show was I on? It was called The Challenger. The producers were dumb as fuck. They let some nigga vote me into the gauntlet the first motherfucking day because I was the littest nigga there, still the littest nigga period from that whole fucking lame ass house. And they let some nigga vote me out the house and fucked up the whole show. After that, the views skunked because nobody wanted to watch anymore because y'all niggas let somebody clip me off the show the first time. And it didn't make fucking sense because the way it worked was so dumb. So whoever wrote the idea of the show was a fucking idiot. Because all you had to do was make it correctly. So they made it to where, yeah, I'll show it in a minute. They made it so, like, this is the way the dumbass niggas had it set up. They had it set up to be like, all right, whoever wins the first challenge could vote somebody into the gauntlet, and that person could then vote somebody into the gauntlet. Tell me that's one of the dumbest, and I mean the dumbest motherfucking ways to structure a show. I was just like, man, I knew I was gonna be the first nigga picked too. I'm like, man, I'm the littest nigga here. I already know whoever's the first person to go into the gauntlet is gonna put me into the gauntlet. I already knew that shit. So I was just going there just for clout, basically, just to up my ante clout, but I wasn't even able to display it because they let some nigga vote me off the show the first motherfucking challenge. That was the first nigga, the first day we were there, I was in the gauntlet. I don't know, I think it was like 7 episodes. I stopped watching after like episode 2. Yup, they let some nigga vote me in this shit. Like I said, I'm the littest nigga that was on that show. And I triumphed everybody on that bitch.
Yo, so what did I miss, man? The fuck did I miss?
But anyways, yeah, it was that bullshit. And all of us got paid $500 and to be treated like kings for a week. So that was the good
part. Don't
know? To me, it was more about the experience. Fuck the money. The experience was good in itself. We could have did that shit for free.
Yo, this caffeine got me going crazy, bro.
Yeah, nobody. Once I got sent home, nobody cared to watch the show. Of course, the nigga to vote me off was black. I forgot his name, but yeah, the nigga that voted me off was black.
Wow, you forgot his name?
Accusations.
Oh, he's so hurt, bro. You so fucking hurt, man. You talk.
I would be the type of nigga in Hollywood where bitches would have to chase me to bank. I wouldn't be like sending DMs, sending people to hotel.
And oh, it's a good ass cope, bro.
None of that bullshit.
This is good.
Do another reality
show? This is a good cope, man. This is good as hell, bro. Good job, though.
Bro, they fumbled the whole bag when they let a nigga vote me off the first day. Because I went in there anyway. I went in there. Remember, when I first went into the house, I didn't know frame data. So I'm just playing Urian against Karen. And I'm still like, you know, I'm still like wet behind the ears of what frame data was and shit like that. I'm like, man, I already know I'm about to lose to whoever I go into the gauntlet with. Unless it was like Dayasha or something. Everybody else I felt like I was going to lose to. Because these niggas was like studying the game and trying to be real gamers and all that shit. I'm like, man, I've been doing this shit. But, yeah. Yup, I got eliminated the first episode, bro.
So you mean to tell me that you don't know Rob TV? Even though Rob TV is literally interviewing...
How many of you guys think I should send...
He's literally interviewing Hollywood stars.
Special surprise.
You don't know who he is. Right now.
Yo, first off, before I talk about this shit, why the fuck did we bring this... Why the fuck did I bring this shit up again? Let's get back to that goal of 4,400 tonight, too, guys. Let's get it. You know, when you take days off... the frame data situation. African insider, huh? Wait, does this one show like who got voted off or some shit? Alright. Whatever, we'll just let this bullshit play.
Hey, how's it going?
You see how they got the champion?
Where's LTG? He's the only one
Episode one? So how you gonna market the whole show? These niggas market the whole show around me to let me get voted off the first day. Flop. So whoever was the producer of the show, they should have pulled whoever voted me off to the side and been like, okay, you can't vote him off. We need more drama. Do you mind picking somebody else? We actually need this for TV.
I've seen the stuff that he says online, and I swear to God, it looks your God.
And his outfit I would never wear again. Actually, niggas are wearing this shit again. Actually, they're just piecing it up with Tim's. So instead of these like Chelsea boot things, they're just wearing baggier pants, a flannel with Tim's.
Stuff that he says online, and I swear to God, if most of your God says anything to me, I'm fighting him on sight.
My name's DeLon Sparrow. I'm from Lancaster, California.
He's gonna say how good looking he is. Watch this shit, bro. Watch.
Online, I'm always. Also, this part right here, guys. They had me doing a whole scene for 8 hours to put 5 seconds.
Angry compared to everybody else. I'm always raging.
Called this guy out. Called him a has-been. Called him a Charles Manson. Anything you could think of.
People just look at me as just a complete.
This is funny.
Yes, mother.
It's gotten really crazy over the years. This is what Street Fighter brought me to.
And I faked it too. I faked it. They said, all right, act like this thing really means it to you. I said, all right, bet. All right, listen to this part. Clearly, I didn't give a fuck, but I was just like, cool, I'm gonna be on TV. Watch
me over the years.
This part right here.
This is what Street Fighter brought me to. This competition, it means absolutely everything to me.
That shit was fake. I didn't give a fuck. That shit was fake. They was like, all right, we need you to really sell it, that this thing, like, just make it like it means everything to you. I said all right cool. They literally told me to do that shit. Like, they told me right here too. Look, check this out.
Fighter brought me too.
This shit right here, they said, all right, act like you just lost and you're raging. So I like played a fake game, and I was like, fuck. That's how I know reality TV is fake, bro. I watch it, but I know it's fake because I did it.
This competition, it means absolutely everything to me. I just got to thank the troll.
All right, so this part right here, when you come in, they say, all right, act like you're super excited to get into the house.
This man literally said, I got to thank the trolls. I got to thank the trolls. Why the fuck are you bitching, man?
Absolutely everything.
Why the fuck are you bitching about the trolls, like, bro?
This was like one of my rooms, right? And they like set the whole shit up crazy. They put Street Fighter in the back, had lighting. They morphed my whole house to a set.
I just gotta thank the trolls for this. I gotta thank the trolls.
You listen to this?
I can't believe that I'm actually here.
That shit tells you everything.
I faked that whole part.
That shit tells you everything, bro. That's not fake. That's not fucking fake. You fucking liar. That's not fake, bro.
It was like, look. They said, when you come in the house, guys, act excited. So, Lil Tiergod, when you come in the house, just act excited. Just act like you've never seen this house before.
That is cap.
It's phenomenal. I said, all right, bet.
Shut the fuck up, bro. You know you lying, man.
Just got to thank the trolls for this. I got to thank the trolls for this. I can't believe they're actually in here.
LTG has
veins popping out my neck and everything, bro. See, here's the thing, guys. All right, check this out. Do you want to know why, like, so obviously I've taken numerous acting classes, everything. Do you know why, like, when I act, so here's how you could really fuck up being a bad actor. All right, so check this out. Here's how you could fuck up being a bad actor. Because when you do something on set, the director is going to tell you to redo it a certain way. You got lighting, cameras. They're going to like, it's kind of hard to fuck that up. So if you do a scene, right? If you do a scene, they literally will make you redo it a certain way and tell you to like, no, we need you to say it with more enthusiasm. Like, really get into this shit. Really get. Bro, you got lights, you got cameras, you got a director redoing your scene. Bro, it's so much shit that goes into it.
Phenomenal. So here we see Dale fucking figured out 30 years into life that making a movie is not just the acting. You need a lighting department, you need a sound department, you need a camera department, you need a lot of different people to make a movie. Apparently, when Dale saw credits at the end of movies, those were too many words for him to see at the same time, and his little small retarded brain couldn't figure it out. What kind of revelation is this? I mean, I just fucking realized something. Did you know that in movies, they're not just actors? Somebody gotta hold the camera.
Said a lot of personal things on the internet.
I actually think Guilty, I think they re-transitioned or some shit like that.
Me, and I want to take him out.
Are you the low-tier god?
Yeah,
exactly.
The
real low-tier
god.
Well, I seem to remember some stuff you've been saying about me on the internet. Oh!
Yo, he looks so goofy, IRO, bro. This dude's a fucking goofball,
okay,
IRO.
Don't worry.
Look at his face, man.
It would
look at this dude's fucking face.
It would really mean a lot for me to blow him up and make him eat all the trash that he's been talking.
Hey, Moz, time that nigga out, bro. Somebody added me. All right, let's fast forward to me. Fuck everybody else.
You're just those on.
But not least, low tier god.
Put those on.
Wait, hold on.
Put those on.
Low tier god.
I was like, do I have dimples right there? Seeing the smile. Bro, everything I did on this motherfucker was fake. So I still got the shirt? Nah, I gave it away. It was like some H&M shit. How you shrink your face? Diet. So, let's see. For this face, all white meat, no snacking. A lot of greens. No sugar.
Bro, yo, Lil Tier Waifu, thanks for the three, man.
Alright, I'm a fix
Lil
that.
Lil Tier Waifu donated $3.42.
Cut your cars,
I hope
too.
Someone mentions him looking younger in
so
that
right
video.
So right now, like, let's just say like tonight, I really shouldn't eat anything with carbs at all. Was I drinking Red Bulls? Was I? Always go through periods when I do and don't. Because if I'm smiling like that. Like, what is this? Yeah, I gotta lower my body fat percentage.
Put those on and then put your game face on.
So we'll meet you guys back here to get into our first.
Yo, Ball Rock, thanks for the 3 months.
Hokage Bull Rock donated $3.42. I miss Prime Cookly LTG. Now we got to deal with Grumpy Old Head LTG.
Which guy voted me out? I forgot. Somebody black in the house. You said you lost yours too? Why do you think you lost yours? I never even knew I had dimples until I seen this scene. It's something I never paid attention to. I don't think... Well, I know JB still plays. I'm not sure if Jesse still plays. I know Guilty doesn't play. I know Sherry just plays casually, goes here and there, but... Yeah, none of us really play. The other guy in the house that voted me off, I don't think he plays. I didn't even know I had dimples, bro. Because if I smile, I don't have them shits no more. I think I was dumb skinny here, too. Like, I was mad skinny here, too. So I look at my legs back then, bro. I was like blue face skinny right here. How much did I weigh here? Maybe like 180.
Yeah, I'm like 219 now. I'm 219 now. So that's completely two different body types. Like all, like literally, I went into my closet and I had hella denim. I couldn't fit none of them 34s. I had hella denim. I'm like, I'm just going through my closet, just looking at different shit. I'm like, what? I can't fit into any of those jeans. Like none of them. I can't fit into none of them 34s that was cut. Certain eras, I'm like, I gotta wear like flare denim for swag now, and I gotta make sure my shit's 36. My waist is still at 31 though, that's the funny thing. Like my waist is still like, did they have a sleep? Did they have a sleep? Yeah. I'm not gonna front, the experience was fire, bro. This is one of the most funnest times I ever had in my life. It wasn't even about the money. But
I think it was just dumb the way they produced the show, and directed it to the point where like you had me as like the intro to the show, and then you allowed somebody to vote me off the first day. Like I think that shit was wild. You said, shoes I wore in this clip, I know it was some 2018 type shit. It was like that whole H&M vibe. Remember when we could just go in H&M and get a whole fit, like, nigga, this whole fit was H&M. The fucking fucking boots. The mother, actually, I got the boots from Kohl's. I got the fucking pants from H&M. The undershirt from H&M. The shirt from H&M. I know you motherfuckers remember the H&M days, right?
All right, let's see this first episode bullshit. I never even seen this shit before.
All right. We're back
on
Dear God.
We're
Rob TV.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even know frame data back then, bro. So they had the only other black nigga voting
Jacob,
me out.
Jacob, what's good,
bro? Basically, JB won the competition. He won basically all the competitions. I think JB won every competition besides one competition. And I was just like, bro, whoever wins the first competition is going to send me into the gulag. I didn't know frame data back then. I was just like, just playing raw Street Fighter back then. So JB beat everybody in like every competition, like won all the prizes, all that type of shit. I just knew once I seen it was another black nigga in the house, I figured I was gonna get voted by one of the black niggas. You know how it is.
Incredible, bro.
Oh, Icy and Xena? Yeah, Xena's the homie.
Urien versus Guile.
It's definitely about to get real, right?
Me pick that outfit.
Oh. Right, bro, I did not know frame data here at all. Wow. Trades up already. I'm just playing raw Trades Street Fighter.
Up already. Jump in, he got the down two into the flash kick.
Bro, Street Fighter 5 was low-key fun, man.
Pressure already.
Wow, you see, yeah, the corner pressure really. B skill is so important for it.
Should have just took the button on the jump in, tried to go for something bigger. Did not work out EX knees.
Yeah, I think it's so important in this matchup actually for you to get B skill out.
You said you showed some girls a rage comp of me. They said I was sexy. I appreciate it. I'm still a sexy guy.
Yeah, even in situations, B trigger 2, new edition, armor available.
Yo, Maz, did you get that dude who I was supposed to play in Street Fighter 6? His info? Man, fuck this game. Look. Get to the end. Oh, yeah, this shit was mad, bro. This shit was fuck. Look how skinny my face was. You could see folds and everything, bro. I was skinny as hell back then. It's good to go. All right, bet.
I like when he reports shit on live, bro. Nakano, thanks for the 3. Yo, he's reporting shit on live. I love that.